Hey, what's going on? I'm LaPrentiss Demond, and in today's video, we are going to do a review on San Pellegrino water. All right, let's go ahead and open this up. It's supposed to be a natural mineral water. It's a little bubbly. Awesome, and we are going to test this against this electrolyzed or reduced water. All right, let's get it going. So the first thing we are gonna test for is antioxidants. And this is the most important portion of everything that we're gonna be testing today. And the reason why is because we have all these things around us known as free radicals, and they are everywhere. They're in our phones, they're in our food, even in the air that we breathe. And these free radicals, they come in and they take the electrons from our healthy cells. And when that happens, that creates oxidation and inflammation. And those two things are linked to every single health disease known to man. So that ends up leading to pretty much our cells rusting, okay? Aging, sickness, and dis-ease, okay? And so we gotta have those antioxidants. These are found in your fruits, your vegetables, your vitamin A, vitamin C, and vitamin E. They actually bring electrons and put them back into our cells, which is going to remove that oxidation, lower that inflammation, and keep us looking young and healthy, okay? How do we test that though? We find that by using an ORP meter. If we see a positive number here, that means it's oxidizing us and it's creating more harm in the body. If we see a negative number, then that means it's an antioxidant, anti-inflammatory. So let's see what we get here with Pellegrino water. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. All right. Let's see what we get. All right. So I see a 2. Oh wow, it's going up. So that carbonation looks like it's playing a pretty strong role here. It's looking at 320, okay? 327 is going up. Yeah, I'll say around 3, it's going higher. So we'll say 330, right? Even though it's looking like 340, and I wanna say it's that carbonation. Yeah, this is going crazy, okay? Let's go ahead and compare it though to this electrolyzed reduced water. Let's see how this does. Wow, look at that. That's the opposite direction, negative 750. Check that dash. That's a negative number, which means that it's a very, very strong antioxidant. And I think over on our little chart there, it only goes up to like a negative 400. This is almost doing double that. And it's really, really strong antioxidant. And the reason why for this is because there's hydrogen in it. And hydrogen is the strongest antioxidant known to man. Okay, so that's just something to keep in mind. So already, looking at San Pellegrino, it's oxidizing us, like on a big way. So that concludes this first test. Let's go ahead and jump onto that second test, which is on alkalinity. All right, onto that second test, which is all about alkalinity. And we want to make sure that our blood maintains a proper alkalinity. We want it slightly alkaline, okay? Our blood is 80% water, so it makes sense that the water that we're drinking is alkaline over acidic, okay? So the question is, what are we drinking and is it acidic or alkaline? If we're consuming things that are acidic all the time, in addition to our foods, we're consuming beverages that are acidic, our body is looking for those electrolytes, okay, to balance out all that acidity. If we're not providing it, then it's gonna start taking it from us. It's gonna start taking it from our skin. This is how we end up having crunchy and ashy looking skin all the time. It's gonna start taking it from our bones, our joints, and our ligaments. And this is how we end up popping bones and not being able to do the physical workouts we enjoy because we're in constant pain. It's how osteoporosis happens. If it continues, we can have Alzheimer's, okay? So it's vitally important that we balance out all that acidic stuff that we're consuming with some stuff that's alkaline, right? With that being said, I add these pH drops. pH stands for potential hydrogen, okay? And I'm adding these drops into both of these beverages. If we see a red or orange or yellow, we know that's acidic and it's eating the minerals and electrolytes in our body. If we see a blue or purple or dark purple, we know it's alkaline and it's helping bring balance, okay? Let's see what we get. Wow, there you have it. This is acidic. Clearly, we can see this, look at this. And it makes sense because it's carbonated. Carbonated beverages are acidic. This is not, I don't even see any real ingredients here. It's carbonated mineral water. So any carbonation is gonna lead to acidity, okay? Just keep that in mind. So all of your sodas, anything that has carbon in it, carbonation is gonna be acidic. It's gonna show up that way and it's not great for our health, okay? So keep that in mind. If you're looking at hydrating, this is not gonna hydrate you. Actually, if you're looking for alkalinity, this is not it, all right? With that being said, let's jump into that third and final test that we have coming up. All right, on to our third and final test. But actually, before I do that, if you're curious about this water, if you're asking like, man, what water does he recommend drinking? This is what I recommend drinking. And if you're interested in that, I have a masterclass down below. So go ahead and click the description portion of this video. Go ahead and click that link. It's gonna take you to my free masterclass that shares with you exactly how this water works, how to have it in the comfort of your home, and save thousands of dollars in the process as you drink one of the world's best waters. All right, now let's go ahead and finish on with our final test, and this is on superior hydration. Our water should actually hydrate us. It shouldn't dehydrate us, okay? So a great way to test that is by making tea. You're probably thinking, LaPrentiss, like, why? Like, how are you making tea? It's, you're gonna boil water in front of us? No, I'm not gonna do that. What I'm gonna do though is we're gonna see if this water can actually pass through the tea bag. Water that is actually able to hydrate us is gonna be a much smaller size, in smaller like little packets. And there's actually a difference of big water and small water. So we're gonna check and see if this water is too big or too small to actually make tea. Sounds crazy, I know. Just work with me here, all right? Let's see what we get here with Pellegrino water. Oh my gosh, look at this. The bag is all puffy, it's all inflated. There's no way I'm getting any water out of this. Oh my gosh, or getting any tea. And this is, look at this bag. This is like literally what happens when we drink a carbonated beverage, right? We get all big and puffy. Filled up with a lot of gas, have to burp. So yeah, we are barely getting any tea and I'm having to bounce this up and down to get some, to get a little bit, to get something, right? This is definitely not hydrating us at that cellular level that we want. Let's see what happens with this electrolyzed reduced water. Look at that. Immediately starts making tea. And there's, this water is cold, there ain't nothing to it. It's just that's a smaller water. And so it's actually able to go through the tea bag and actually pull out the nutrients, which is great because our water is a vehicle. It actually delivers those minerals, those electrolytes that we're talking about when it comes to pH. And at the same time, once it gets into the cells, it helps push out the waste. And it carries it through the lymphatic system so we can get rid of it, okay? But let's try one more time. I have a little bit left, we'll see what happens. No, I don't think we're getting anything out of this. Stuff is not, it just makes you feel bloated, right? I don't think there's much minerals in here for it to be a mineral water, right? But see with the right water though. Man, we immediately start to feel a lot better and be a lot better, okay? So there you have it. That is the T-test. That's why I call it the T-test. And as you see, this water does nothing when it comes to hydrating us. So let's go ahead and wrap up this review. All right, for our conclusion, we tested San Pellegrino water, tested for three specific things. First one was antioxidants, and we saw that this is oxidizing. This was like around a 300, 320, something like that. And then we tested it for alkalinity. And then we saw that's acidic on top of that. This is a carbonated beverage. Every carbonated beverage is pretty much gonna fall in line with this, okay? And guess what? It takes a lot of water to neutralize a soda or a carbonated beverage, okay? So you really want to stay away from these if you're serious about improving your health. Last but not least, we tested it for superior hydration to see if it actually hydrates us at a cellular level, and it doesn't. Probably because of all that carbonation that's blocking it off, okay? So there you have it. That's my review on San Pellegrino water. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, let me know down in the comments below. Give me a like, smash that subscribe button. And if you want to learn more about this water, check out what I have for you coming up. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it and you learned a little something about the waters that we tested here today. Please take a moment to share this video with someone you care about who is also drinking this water. Finally, if you are serious about improving your health and the waters that you drink, click the link in the description below to access my Water Wellness Masterclass. In this masterclass, you will discover the truth about the waters we drink, the effects our water has on our health, and how you can have the world's best water in the comfort of your home and save thousands of dollars as a result. All right, go ahead, click that link in the description below. Access that masterclass, and I will see you there real soon.